Hi, Michael.
Hey, Charles. How you doing?
I'm doing just fine. How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
Excellent. We are on our penultimate topic in unsupervised learning.
Huh, that seems kind of fast.
It does seem kind of fast, but we'll probably go back and pad things so that it seems longer.
Maybe we could just talk more slowly.
I'm not really sure I'm capable of that, but I'll do my best to talk more slowly. So today what we're going to talk about is feature selection.
Ah, nice. Ah.
Now, it turns out that this is one of two topics that we'll be talking about. That's what I meant by penultimate. And the other is feature transformation, which is something that has a long history and is very interesting in its own way. But I think it's better to talk about feature selection first. It's a nice, crisp problem. Okay?
Sure. And then this is in the unsupervised setting?
Yes, this is in the unsupervised setting. Though it'll turn out that, as is often the case, it's not clear what it means to do something in the unsupervised setting in the absence of some supervision later down the road. But we'll see that as we talk in a couple of minutes.
Cool.
Okay? All right. So the first thing that we should do, I think, for feature selection is define the problem.